YouTube, it's KD, and welcome to another video. Today we are going to be talking about the college courses of an animation student. I am a college junior senior. I'm going to be junior in the fall and a senior in the spring, and I just finished my first semester. I'm in a weird place in college. I'm a college student who's majored in animation. This semester, I had to take motion graphics. Now, what is motion graphics other than a requirement for my major? I didn't know either. That's the same thing I was asking myself going into the class. Motion graphics, as my professor geniusly explained it, is basically the art of credits. The credit sequences in movies, such as Monsters, Inc. and the original Incredibles, are good examples. Motion graphics focuses on interesting ways of moving text and images to sort of make the appearance of animation, but not quite so well rendered, and also make text a bit more dynamic and interesting for a viewer to look at. So I know that explanation is really static and boring, but motion graphics projects were so much fun, and I loved the class. We worked exclusively in After Effects, Adobe After Effects. It is a program that is like sort of like Final Cut Pro, I think, in that you have multiple tracks and you can edit video, but it's really honestly not even for that. It's compatible with Photoshop and Illustrator, so you can insert your other files, and it's good for making things like parallax photos, which I did a lot of in my final project. Parallax photos are still, you know, chick-chick pictures that you then put into the computer and make move. And the way you do that is through motion graphics in After Effects. So it was really fun. Our first project was a way to take a still image and make it move. One of two main ways that's done in After Effects. One of the main ways is a puppet pin, which I used in the last project. And the other main way is cutting up your image into the important parts and then moving them. For example, if you have an image of an arm and you want it to wave, you would cut out the hand in Photoshop, make that one layer. Cut out the forearm in Photoshop, make that another layer. Cut out the bicep in Photoshop, make that another layer, move this Photoshop file into After Effects, and then tell After Effects, put the hand here, 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 put the arm here, 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 and put the bicep here, 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 and then you wave. It's magic. It's not magic though, it's basically just animation. The difference is you start with a still image, and you use that still image all the way through, rather than drawing multiple images. So my first project was to take a classical painting, sculpture, some sort of classical art piece, and put a modern twist on it using these After Effects tricks. I chose little Claude Monet's paintings because he is one of my favorite painters. The Impressionism style is so hard for me to imitate, but I love it, and someday I will get there. So I chose little Claude Monet's paintings, and I did this with it. So I know the sound effects at the end were a little corny, but I did the best that I could. And I honestly think my first project was a good start and a good way to get myself acclimated into After Effects. So for our second project, our professor wanted to do what I think he thought would be a little simpler, but what I made a little extra. He wanted us to focus on text, so he wanted us to take an audio clip of any kind. Most of us chose a song, but some people chose like a movie scene, and basically create a lyric video or animate the text. So I chose a song from Dear Evan Hansen, the most amazing Broadway musical that has ever lived, or that I've ever seen at least, and I basically just made a lyric video for the song, and I focused on the theme colors that Dear Evan Hansen uses in its poster, which is this sort of lightish blue, and I used one or two fonts through the whole thing. There was one main font, but I had another. A lot of the text animation just isn't text animation. I mostly focus on animating the background and just put the text in there, but there are a few things that I do with the text, like use the 3D camera. The 3D camera is an amazing tool in After Effects that allows you to take two-dimensional things and use them like they're in a 3D plane. So it's kind of like it lets you fly through the clouds that I do in this clip. I fly through the clouds and fly past certain texts, and I use the 3D camera in my last project a lot. So if you don't know how to use After Effects 3D camera, I really recommend looking up a tutorial for it because it's so cool, the stuff you can do with it. But anyways, here's my second project focusing on text.
And there he goes, racing toward the tallest tree. From far across a yellow field, I hear him calling, follow me. There we go, wondering how the world might look from up so high. One foot after the other, one branch then to another. I climb higher and higher, I climb till the entire sun shines on my face.
So for project two, I really enjoyed the overall look of it. I really liked making my own assets in Photoshop, like, you know, the boy running and stuff. That was really fun, honestly. I loved my color scheme. I think that I could have made bigger assets, like made the file size more pixels, so that things wouldn't look so pixelated and blurry sometimes when I zoomed in. But I think other than that, it came out really well. I'm honestly really happy with that project. And I like the timing of the hands, like climbing up the tree. I just really enjoyed that project. So for our third project, our professor gave us a couple of options because he knew a lot of the students in the class were animation majors and were going to focus on animation, but motion graphics isn't only for animation. Our professor either wanted us to focus on an animated lip sync project or on an After Effects project, making a sort of commercial for a TV show, but I chose the animated lip sync project. I chose a story time that I thought was particularly interesting. The one that I chose was by the spookiest ghost, and I wanted to animate her whole video in theory, but honestly, I didn't have time for that, so that's tea.
A 35-year-old man is insulting and basically bullying a 13-year-old girl. And let me explain why. He didn't call me into his office because I did something wrong. He called me into his office to tell me that he knew that I was lying about my anxiety disorder and that I was just too stupid and lazy to come to school. He had the phone number of my therapist and my psychiatrist. Like, why would I be seeing a therapist and a psychiatrist if I didn't have an anxiety disorder? And the next thing I know, I wake up in a chair with EMT looking into my eyes with like a flashlight. A few years later, my mom told me that apparently when they called 911, they told them that they have a student who faked a seizure.
I knew I wanted to animate a black character, even though I don't think the spookiest ghost is black, so I apologize for that. But the challenges with this project are things that were basically me figuring out how to do this, and so if I ever need to animate an After Effects again, I now know the kinds of mistakes that I will make and how to fix them. For example, her eyes, like her actual irises, can't move. I didn't make them on a separate layer in Photoshop, so that's something to fix. To make the eyelid and like the eye socket and irises all separate layers. Maybe even the pupils if you want to get into that level of detail, okay? But her eyes couldn't move. Another thing was there were lots of things where like her arm, where I just drew her and then cut it out. So if her arm were to move, there would just be a big gap there. So I had to go back and redraw a lot of things in Photoshop and redraw. Touching your Photoshop file after you've already put it into After Effects really messes things up. It slowed me down a lot. I had to just do a lot of relayering, removing. It was just a lot of mistakes that I made in this project. Didn't really enjoy the lip syncing. I did all the lip syncing first because I knew it was going to get annoying, and boy oh boy was I right, because it got annoying. But once I had it all done, I thought that mine looked really nice. I thought that there was a lot of expression in her and what I could do without her eyes being able to move, and I think that overall I did a decent job. I think I had to cut the audio down a bit too much to, you know, not go crazy with doing lip sync all day, so I think maybe the story doesn't make much sense, but my professor seemed to understand it, so I think if you really listen, you can tell what I was talking about with that project. So for project four, I chose to go onto a different route and focus more on the motion graphics aspects that aren't strictly animation. So to do that, I decided to create an intro sequence for a TV show. And when deciding what TV show I wanted to use, I decided to make up my own show. So this show is theoretically about a blonde girl who has magical powers and a redhead girl who also has powers. I think their powers are that the blonde girl can make like energy fields and that the redhaired girl can teleport. That's what I think I was going with, but it's not clearly defined. The show is called Druid Hill. You know, Druid is like a sorcerer, like a magic person, you know, and Hill is a location. So it's all these sorcerer girls in a small town who are solving a mystery. It's sort of like a science fiction supernatural mystery show with a bit of thriller sprinkled in there. So here is the Druid Hill intro sequence that I made.
It's my oldest desire. It's my old remorse. Help me to decide. Help me make the most of freedom. Of pleasure, nothing ever lasts forever. Everybody wants to rule the world. There's a room where the light won't find you. Holding hands while the walls come tumbling down. When they do, I'll be right behind you. So glad we've almost made it. So sad we had to fade it.
Footage, the girl in the dress walking around in slow motion and like turning and smiling, that scene that I used throughout it was a video. And then the girl like, yeah, like with the energy field, that was also a scene that I snatched, we're not gonna say stole, that I borrowed from Marvel's Cloak and Dagger. I don't make any money off of that project, so it's fine that I'm using things that aren't mine. But the rest are images that I got from a, you know, copyright-free image website, free to use, and also through fair use. I changed up the images so much by making them parallax that I think it's okay anyways. So like in the beginning, the girl standing there with the piece of paper is one image, and her background is another image, and then all the books falling are another image, and I put those images together in After Effects, made them move, and then used a 3D camera to get, like, you know, some of the effects, and that's kind of how I did the whole thing. A lot of 3D camera and a lot of parallax images, and I think it came out looking really cool. I don't love it. It's not my favorite thing I've made. I think my favorite thing was Project 2 with the text. This one, I didn't really enjoy the parts where I had to use video so much, and I didn't enjoy some of my parallax. Like, holding hands while the walls come tumbling down, I didn't love the parallax that I made for that scene. Also, the video of me, like, walking through the door, that one ended up in there because I didn't like the parallax that I made for that scene so much, and I was kind of running out of time, that I just decided to get a video of someone walking through a door and put that in there. So I didn't love that. I liked playing with the glitch effects. And with this project, I think that for the time that I had, it came out really well. Because honestly, I struggled a lot in the beginning with figuring out what I was doing for this project. So since I wasted so much time, like, starting projects and not really liking where they were going and having to restart and having a lot of difficulties, I think because I, like, lost so much time doing that, but the time that I did have left, maybe, I think we had 6 weeks to do this project, and I think I probably did mine in 3 or 4 because I was just confused in the beginning. So I think with the time that I had, I did pretty well. I don't know, that might be just me, but I think that it's pretty decent, but not my favorite thing in the world. But let me know down in the comments below which one of my four projects in motion graphics were your favorite. Do you think motion graphics is something that you would like to do, or do you already do it? And what is your favorite part of After Effects? Do you like the 3D camera? Do you like the parallax? Do you like the text edits? Do you like the do you like the particle effects? Do you like animating with After Effects? Archer, the TV show, is animated with After Effects, for example. Just what kinds of things do you guys like to do if you are doing this stuff? Make sure that you scroll down just ever so slightly. It's like not even that hard, just a little like half scroll, and you'll see a little button. It says subscribe. Just click on it. You know, it ain't even a big deal. There's a bell next to it, and if you click on that, you will be notified every time I post a video. So you and me, we could be close, you could be tight. You can catch me when I do my review of my drawing 2 projects and my computer applications and arts projects, because I did have more than one art class this semester. And heck, man, we might even go into previous semesters. I took oil painting, I took wheel throwing. Okay, we got, boy oh boy, do I have some art for y'all. So I want to thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure you click somewhere on the screen wherever I decide to put them on other videos, and definitely make sure you subscribe. I will see all you guys next time, and until then, doodaloo.